Here when Jesus is using anger, he is repeatedly taking the example of anger directed at others. Today we had a question on anger. What did we say? We said, instead of venting out your anger on external objects, why don't you figure out the root of your anger? Why are you expressing your anger on your brother? Jesus says, if you express your anger on something external, it only shows that you are hiding the real cause of your anger. So he says, no, you are not allowed to do that. You cannot be angry at your brother. Which means that all the energy that expresses itself as anger flowing outwards has to go as self-inquiry flowing inwards. The same energy which turns into a fraudulent escape directed outwards must turn inwards. What is it that I really do not like? What is all this resentment towards? And then you reach the root of your discontentment. The moment you are able to look clearly at the root of your discontentment, it vanishes. Jesus is not giving us a code of conduct. He is not saying suppress anger. Jesus is not giving us a behavior pattern. He is not saying keep smiling because anger is bad. He is saying your anger is a deception. There is nothing morally bad with anger. Jesus himself exhibited anger. But his anger was an honest anger, a pure anger. Our anger is an escape, a cheating. That is why Jesus is against it. Don't you see how calculated our anger is? If the president of the country humiliates you, you will not express your anger at him. But if some helpless man comes and says even a few things to you, then you will express your anger fully. Two men with guns come and slap you, and they are holding big guns. Will you show your displeasure to them? No. Our anger is such an impotent and calculated anger. That is why Jesus is saying, no, such anger is not allowed.